Hello friends, welcome to the revision session. Today we will discuss about the marginal costing. It's a part of management account. We'll start with the unit number 1, marginal costing. See, basically this chapter is based on the formula. Formula about the break-even point. Break-even point means it is a situation where there is no profit or no loss. Okay, you should know about the contribution. Contribution means sales minus variable cost. Okay, you should know about the margin of safety concept. Margin of safety concept means what? It is basically a difference between your actual sales and break-even point. Okay, the above break-even point, whatever sales is made by you, is called margin of safety. Okay, we'll start with the illustration 12, page number 306. Okay, see, I just read the question, you should have the books, right? The following is the information of a business unit. Now in this practical problem, the information is given about the 2 years, 2007 and 2008. Information is given about the sales as well as profit. Okay, so sales information and profit information is given for the year 2007 and 2008. Now the sales for the year 7 is 1 lakh rupees and 8 1 lakh 20,000 rupees. Now the profit is given 10,000 and 14,000. Okay, now the first question is PVR, profit volume ratio. Okay, now see friends, PVR, profit volume ratio. There are two formulas to find out PVR basically, which is widely applied. Right, contribution upon sales into 100, and second formula which is widely used is changes in profit upon changes in sales into 100. Okay, now whenever the information is given about the two periods, right, you should use the formula changes in profit divided by changes in sales into 100. So changes in profit upon changes in sales into 100. Okay, now you can see here the profit for the year 7 is 10,000, profit for the year 8 is 14,000. So what would be the changes? 14,000 minus 10,000, so 4,000 is the changes in the profit divided by changes in sales. Now sales is 120,000 and previously it was 1 lakh rupees. So what is the changes? 20,000 into 100. So the answer would be 20%. Okay, so now 20% is the profit volume ratio. Now second question is profit when sales are 90,000 and 40,000. See friends, if you want to find out the profit, you must have the information regarding the cost as well as revenue. Okay, because revenue minus cost is the basic formula of profit. Okay, now here cost means variable cost as well as fixed cost. Now information is not available regarding the fixed cost, so we'll find out the fixed cost, then only we'll be able to solve this second question. Okay, so first we'll solve your question number 4, that is regarding the fixed expense. Now fixed expense, first thing we'll find out the fixed expense. Now here you can take the sales of 2007 and profit of 2007 or sales and profit of 2008 is a base to find out the fixed costs. Right? There is no rule that you should use only 7 information or 8. You can find out the fixed cost by using information of any year. Okay, there is one formula of sales, right? We call it necessary sales. Now, necessary sales means profit plus fixed cost upon PVR. Okay, so we will take 2007 information. So, sales is given 1 lakh rupees. Sales is 1 lakh. Profit is given 10,000 plus fixed cost is missing divided by PVR. 20%. So 1 lakh into 20%. So 20,000 is equal to 10,000 plus fixed cost. So fixed cost is equal to 20,000 minus 10,000. This will come to this side, so minus. So answer is 10,000 rupees. Okay. Actually, this was question number 4. Okay, fixed expense. Now we'll solve the second question. Now, second question is profit when sales are 90,000 and 40,000. So, you need to find out profit when sales are rupees 90,000 and 40,000 rupees. Friends, please remember when the sales or profit is missing is to be found out. Okay, you should always use this formula. By using this formula, you can find out sales or profit, whichever information is missing. Okay, so using the same formula, first of all, when the sales is 90,000. Formula is necessary sales is equal to profit plus fixed cost divided by PVR. Now sales is given 90,000, then profit is missing, so profit is to be find out fixed cost. 10,000 divided by PVR, that is 20%. So 90,000 multiplied by 20%, so it is 18,000. Okay, profit plus 10,000. So what would be the profit? 18,000 minus 10,000, so it would be 8,000 rupees. And second question is when sales rupees 40,000. Okay, now using the same formula, sales is only differ. Sales is 40,000 and profit plus fixed cost divided by PVR. 40,000 into 20%, so it is 8,000. Profit plus 10,000. So profit is 8,000 minus 10,000, so it is actually loss. Minus means loss. Now coming to the third question, sales to earn profit of 20,000. So here you need to find out sales if profit is 20,000. So profit is given 20,000 and sales is to be find out. So using the same formula, necessary sales, profit plus fixed cost upon period. So here the profit is given 20,000 plus fixed cost is given 10,000 divided by 20% period. So 30,000 divided by 20%. So your sales would be 1,50,000. Fourth question is solved, that is regarding the fixed cost, and last is break even point. BEP. So formula for BEP is fixed cost divided by PBR. So fixed cost is 10,000 divided by PBR 20%. So it is 50,000. Okay, so this question is frequently asked in the university exams also, right? So we'll start with the important sum. It is illustration 11. Illustration 11, page number 304. Now here, the information is given regarding the sales. Sales is given 1 lakh rupees. Any bracket information about the units is also given 1 lakh. That means we can say selling price would be 1 rupees. 1 lakh divided by 1 lakh unit. Variable expense is given 40,000. 40,000 rupees. So what should be the per unit variable cost? 40,000 divided by unit 1 lakh. So it would be per unit 0.4. And fixed expense is given 50,000. Okay, now you need to find out PBR, BEP and margin of safety, right? So three main questions are asked regarding the PBR, BEP and margin of safety, and then after you need to find out the same thing, PBR, BEP and margin of safety in case of some changes. Okay, so 4 ABCD, 4 sub questions are given, right? So first is increase of 20% in number of units sold. That means if there is changes in the number of unit, what would be the changes in the BEP, margin of safety and PBR. Okay, first we start with the main question, that is PBR, BEP and margin of safety. So first thing is PVR. Okay, right? So what is the formula to find out PVR? Contribution upon sales into grade. So contribution means sales minus variable cost. Here the sales is 1 lakh, variable cost is 40,000. So 1 lakh minus 40,000, 60,000 contribution divided by sales 1 lakh into 100. Okay, so your answer is 60%. 60% is the PVR. Okay, right? And second question is BEP. Now BEP means fixed cost upon PVR. So here the fixed cost is 50,000 divided by PBR 60%. Okay, so 50,000 divided by 60%. So your answer would be 83,353.33. Okay. And third question is margin of safety. Now margin of safety means actual sales minus PAP sales. Now here your actual sales is 1 lakh rupees minus BAP, 83,333.33. So your answer would be 16,666.67. That is margin of safety. Okay. These are the three main questions which are asked. Now you need to find out PVR, BAP and margin of safety in case of some changes. First change is increase of 20% in number of units sold. So the first question is increase of 20% in number of units sold. Now number of units sold are asked. So here your units at present is 1 lakh. Plus 20%. So 20,000. And so 1,20,000 units would be the new units. Okay. Right. So first question. And what would be the sales? Selling price is 1 rupees. Okay. So your sales would also be same amount. 1,20,000. Now, first question is PVR. PVR means contribution upon sales into 100. So, contribution sales minus variable cost. Now, here your sales is 1,20,000 minus variable cost is 40,000. Friends, but whenever there would be a changes in your sales units, your variable cost also change, because variable cost is the direct relation to the number of units produced. Okay, so your variable cost will also increase by 20%. So 40,000 plus 20%, so that would be 48,000. And you can also find out, because we have the per unit cost 0.4 multiplied by number of unit 1,20,000. This is also the way to find out variable cost. So your variable cost would be 48,000. So 1,20,000 minus 48,000, and you will get contribution 72,000. This is your contribution. Okay, so contribution divided by sales into 100. So 60% is the PVR. Okay, please remember that variable cost changes or changes in the selling price will only affect the PVR, profit volume ratio. Okay, here we have changed the number of units, so PVR remains same. Okay, now second is BAP. So BAP will also be same. Fixed cost divided by PVR. Your fixed cost is 50,000 divided by PVR 60%. So you will get same answer. 83,333.33. Now margin of safety means actual sales minus BAP. Okay, so actual sales is 1,20,000 minus DET. So it would be 36,666.67. Okay, right. Now we'll solve the second changes. Now the second change is increase of 5% in variable cost. Now variable cost is change. Now variable cost is 40,000 plus 5%. So 40,000 plus 5%. So your new variable cost would be 42,000. Now PVR, contribution, means sales minus variable cost. So sales same amount 1 lakh minus variable cost 42,000. So 58,000 rupees would be the contribution. Okay. Now you get the contribution 58,000 rupees, right? So PVR, contribution divided by sales into 100, so it would be 58%. Now BAP, fixed cost 50,000 divided by PVR 58%. So your BAP will be 86,206.89. So round about 86,207 rupees. And margin of safety, actual sales 1 lakh minus 86,207. So 13,793 rupees. That would be your margin of safety. Okay, actual sales minus break-even point. Now the third change is increase of 10% in fixed cost. Increase of 10% in fixed cost. That means fixed cost is changed. Now fixed cost was 50,000 plus 10%. So your fixed cost would be 55,000. Now PVR means contribution upon sales. So you should use the original data. Okay, right. So what was the original data? 1 lakh sales, 40,000 variable cost. So 60,000 contribution divided by 1 lakh into 100. So PVR 60%. And BAP, fixed cost divided by PVR. So fixed cost is changed. That is 55,000 divided by 60%. So 55,000 divided by 60%, that is 91,666.67. So round about 91,667. And margin of safety, actual sales 1 lakh minus BAP 91,667. So margin of safety 83,343 rupees. Okay. And the last changes, right? In the last changes, there is increase of 10% in selling price. That means selling price is increased by 10%. And decrease in sales by 20%. So sales units as well as selling price both are changed. Okay, so we saw the last changes. In the last, increase of 10% in selling price. And decrease of unit of sales by 20%. Decrease in units sold by 20%. That means your selling price, which was 1 rupees. Selling price means per unit price 1 rupees. It is increased by 10%. So your selling price would be 1.1. Second change is units. 1 lakh. Now it is decreased by 20%. So 1 lakh minus 20,000, so it is 80,000. So total sales would be 80,000 multiplied by 1.1. So it is 88,000. Okay. Now, first question is PVR, contribution upon sales into 100. Contribution means S minus V. So here sales is 88,000 minus variable cost. Now variable cost was 40,000. But earlier also I discussed that whenever there is changes in the sales units, okay, then variable cost also change, right? So it is decreased by 20%, right? Unit sold. So variable cost also decreased by 20%. So 40,000 minus 20%. So it is 32,000. Right? You can also find out, because you have the number of units sold 80,000 multiplied by per unit cost 0.4. So 80,000 into 0.4, 32,000. So your contribution $56,000 divided by sales 88,000 into 100. So 63.636% is your PVR. Okay, now PV. So fixed cost divided by PVR, fixed cost 50,000 divided by PVR 63.636%. So 50,000 divided by 63.636%, then you will get 78,571.88. So round about 78,572. And margin of safety, actual sales 88,000 minus 78,572. Okay, so 78,572 minus So 88,000 minus 78572, you will get 9,428 rupees. That is margin of safety. So this is about the second sum of revision session. We now take third sum, that is sum number 16. Sum number 16, page number 332. Okay. In this sum, information is given regarding the selling price. Selling price is given 20 rupees. Variable cost per unit is given 10 rupees. Fixed cost is given 40,000. And sales is given 1 lakh rupees. Okay. Now the first question is regarding the break-even point in rupees. So break-even point in rupees. So what should be the formula for break-even point? Fixed cost divided by PVR. Okay. So PVR means contribution upon sales into rate. So here selling price 20 rupees, variable cost 10 rupees. So 20 minus 10. So contribution 10 divided by selling price 20 into 100. So 50% would be the PVR. So fixed cost 40,000 divided by PVR 50%. So we'll get the answer, right? 40,000 divided by 50%. So answer is 80,000. You can also find out by using the formula fixed cost. Okay. Upon S minus V into S. Okay, then also you can get the answer. Or alternate formula is fixed cost divided by PVR. Okay, you can apply any of the formula. Now, second, profit volume ratio. Okay. Reason why I use this formula, because PVR is the second question, so you have the answer 50%, right? So this is the benefit of using this formula, right? So PVR that we already find out 50% in the previous question. Now, third question. Margin of safety when sales is 120,000. Okay. Now, you need to find out margin of safety when sales rupees 120,000. So, what is the formula of margin of safety? Sales minus BEP. So here the actual sales is given 120,000 minus BEP 80,000. So the answer is 40,000. Okay. Now the fourth question. Profit when sales is 150,000. Profit when sales 150,000. Now, earlier also I discussed that whenever you need to find out profit or sales, you can use same formula, necessary sales. Profit plus fixed cost upon PVR. necessary cells 150,000, profit is to be find out, fixed cost is given 40,000 divided by PVR 50%. So 150 into 50%, so 75,000 profit plus fixed cost. So profit is 75,000 minus 40,000. So profit amount 35,000 rupees. And last question is, calculate sales if profit target is 50,000. So in the last question, you need to find out sales if profit is 50,000. So by using the same formula, sales is equal to profit plus fixed cost upon PVR. Now profit is given 50,000 plus fixed cost. Fixed cost is also given 40,000 upon PVR. So PVR, that is 50%. So 90,000 divided by 50%. So the answer is 180,000. Okay. So in marginal costing, we have solved some basic sums and frequently asked sums. Okay. Thank you very much.